Welcome to the Lynn Lineup, a program where we focus on events happening right here in the city of Lynn. And here with me today, we have Nicole McClain, and she's a representative from the Juneteenth Committee. And we're here today to talk about the event that's set to happen June 17th, 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. over at the Lynn Commons. And it's the Juneteenth event. We're going to talk about it a little bit more in detail. But first and foremost, Nicole, I want to say thank you for coming on to the program. And I also want to give you an opportunity to explain who you are and how you're involved with the event.
Okay, I'm the creator of the Juneteenth Committee, and I decided to create this committee because I wanted to have some positive representation of African Americans in our community. So that was pretty much my goal. So I guess I am the chair of the committee.
Founder, organizer.
Founder. Yeah,
so
exactly.
Everything's your department.
I am everything.
Wonderful. Well, it's a pleasure to have you here. We're going to talk about Juneteenth, what it is and what it means to American history. But let's talk about the committee overall. How long ago was this started?
It's very new. We started, my thought process began in October of last year. So then I reached out to a couple of my friends to see if they were interested in making this happen too, and they were. So
that's impressive.
Here we are.
That's a good turnaround for a startup organization. Committees, it's tough. Sometimes you get them, sometimes you don't. You'll have meetings and people, I didn't know where
right,
the meeting
exactly.
was. So this event, it's the Lynn Juneteenth Festival. And this is set to happen June 17th from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. over at the Lynn Commons. And I want to talk a little bit about what's going to be available at the event. But first and foremost, let's talk a little bit about the history, about the whole reason why. Juneteenth is a pretty important type of thing for us to recognize in American history. And I'll let you kind of take it away so I don't mess anything up.
Okay, so the Emancipation Proclamation was signed in 1863, announcing the freedom of African American slaves. So that being said, 2 years later in Galveston, Texas, there were still African Americans being held in slavery, and they heard about this around June 19th of 1865. So they received that message saying that they were free then, and they had a celebration in honor of that. So other African Americans have now picked up that as well, and they have been doing it for a long period of time with celebrating that all of us were actually now know that we were free. So it's an important date for African Americans.
I remember being in grammar school all the way up through high school, and you know, obviously hear a lot about the Civil Rights Movement, the Emancipation Proclamation, and that Juneteenth date was just something that always really blew me away. It was like, wow, these guys, like, it's kind of like you're doing something that you don't need to do. And just, I mean, obviously, there must have been some type of relief for these folks, you know, when they heard about this. But
absolutely.
To go 2 extra years in dealing with slavery when they didn't have to, it's so important to recognize, especially when it comes to, you know, developing a thorough understanding on how government can work. Sometimes things can move slower. Obviously, back in the 1800s, it was very slow.
Exactly, and a horseback ride, they have to, you know, get there to tell you. So,
Right. And, you know, it's not like you just send out an email. So it's like something that's really important for us to recognize. So at this event, you guys are going to have a lot of stuff available, from poetry. This is probably going to be strong, really emotional type of poetry. Who else is involved with the event?
We have some spoken word people that are involved from Mass Poetry, the Mass Poetry organization. And we have some artwork hopefully being given to us by Raw Arts, and also a place in Cambridge that deals with artists. And we're going to have some vendors. We're still looking for more vendors, so if anyone's interested in vending for the event.
What about volunteers? Do you need volunteers for it other than
vendors? We have some volunteers from a college. I believe it's Gordon College.
Beautiful.
It's going to be volunteering some of their students.
Beautiful.
So we have some, but I mean, the more the merrier.
Right.
I don't see why not. You know.
So this is probably going to be an ongoing effort that you do each year.
I would love to have it be
in
that.
The development of the committee, you guys will probably be looking for more committee members, for more ways for people to get involved.
And absolutely.
If you're at home and you're interested, you reach out to the information at the bottom of the screen to find out more ways to actually get involved. So poetry, dancing, games, food, which is a big
Food needs
speaker.
To be there.
All right. It's got to be there.
Yeah, that has to be there.
Folks, without a doubt. Now, Juneteenth is something that, you know, not a lot of people speak about in mm-hmm. General. I think it's important, and we owe it to these people to really kind of highlight this. So I want to say thanks for doing what you're doing. Mm-hmm. At the event, you guys will definitely have everything from poetry and all that type of stuff. If there's anybody at home on the fence as to, you know, why they may want to go, this is your selling point. How would you tell these guys, hey, this will be a great event, you should come on down, without saying this is a great event,
you should come on down.
It's free. It's a free event.
Right. It's absolutely free. Absolutely. Okay. I mean, you're going to get information that you didn't know before. You're going to have a little history there. There's going to be some African dance. Most people in our community, I don't think, have ever been exposed to African dance, so that's something great to be able to come down and see. We're going to have some drummers, some African drums there as well. So,
beautiful.
I mean, I think in food. Mm-hmm. So I think, come
and
down.
Food.
Yeah.
The overall benefit to the community, really just speaks volumes to me, is like, we're here to kind of create an awareness about, culture, African-American culture.
Yes.
They get a little bit of spin on the history of it, mm-hmm. and its importance to the development of all American cultures. And
absolutely.
I mean, how
it is American it is. History.
Right. Absolutely.
So, yeah. So it should definitely be, come down and share in the new information that you can get about our American history. It's all of our history, so come down and hear some things, see some sights.
If there are some folks at home wondering where they can find some additional resources to learn about the subject matter, mm-hmm. can you speak on that at all?
Absolutely. They have at the library, Lynn Public Library, they have some books about Juneteenth, and in the children's area, they have some books about Juneteenth there as well. I mean, me personally, I have looked on the National Juneteenth website. There's actually a website for Juneteenth. It's called National Juneteenth. Well, it'd be Juneteenth.org. So
okay.
you can go there and find out some more information about it. And they're trying to make it a national holiday, so you can sign the petition as well on that website.
Yeah, it
should
be.
To make it a national holiday.
It should be,
yeah.
Definitely, without a doubt. Mm-hmm. Well, I just want to say thanks for what you're doing. This benefit to the community, it really speaks a lot of volumes. And, as anybody who's sitting at home and wondering if, they can make a difference or they can raise awareness, you're a model citizen in being able to do that. Just do it,
right? That's right.
It takes
just
less
do
than
it.
A year
yeah,
to achieve. So definitely, guys, if you're interested, it's a free event. It's going to be down at the Lynn Commons on June 17th, 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Come on down. There's going to be food and dance and all different types of ways to really expose yourself to the culture and learn a little bit about American history. I want to say thank you to my guest, Nicole McClain, for coming on to the program. Thanks to my crew here, and thanks to you for watching. That's it for the Lynn Lineup from the studio here at Lynn Community Television. I'm Sean Donahue, wishing you all the best.